In this video, we're going to look at if-then statements. If-then statements are great because of the functionality of them and the fact that they can be creating increasingly more complex functions. So they're a really good thing to learn how to use, which is what we'll start to do today by focusing on two very simple ways. Essentially, the way they work is we say that if a value in a cell meets a condition, then return this. So to give you an example here, I've got two set up. They can be used with text and numbers. They can also be used with mathematical formulas. So what we're going to do here is we're going to say equals if. Now the first thing we have to do is our logical test. Now our logical test is based not on a range but on the single cell, which is this one. So it says ask class level, which would of course be D2. Now what we're going to do is if D2, we're going to say is if D2 equals H. So because we're using text, we'll put it in quotation marks. You notice we don't do a comma after class level for this. We just say if class level equals H. So here's the then part of the statement. So the value of true. So if that's true, then what we're going to do is we're going to take I2 and we're going to add to it 3 points. And we'll do a comma. Now, if it's false, if we stop right here and put parentheses, it's going to label areas false, which we don't want to do. What we're going to do next is that we're just going to do quotation, quotation, and then close it. And the quotations there will make the false blank. So when we hit enter, you'll see that it comes up and it shows nothing. Now, when we drag that down, you'll see that the scores here have 3 points added to them. So in this statement, what we said is if it is an honors class, then add 3 points to that student's test average, which is exactly what we did right there. Now, a second example would be if we walked over here to remediation and we did the same thing. So we're going to say equals if. Now, in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to say equals if. Now, you'll see here if a student's average is below a 75. So if the average here, I2, if that average is below a 75. Notice we don't use the comma, we just use the 75 here. So then what we're going to do next is so remark them for remediation. So if that's true, then we'll say yes. If it's false, then we'll just do quotation, quotation, and it'll show up blank. So as we autofill down, you'll see all of the ones that the average is below a 75. These are all students that we have listed for remediation. Now notice this one here is a 75. We said everything less than a 75, so this one doesn't count, but the 72.8 does, and so it listed as yes. So what happens, of course, is this formula is specifically designed to basically go through this and weed out and say, okay, if something occurs here, then this is what's going to take place. Now, what we can do is we can actually, in a more complicated way, is we can use these nested, which means that we can actually say if is this, and if it's this, and if it's this, then do this. But that's something we'll learn at a later time.